What's up, DC Nation? Welcome back to another video on DC Infinite Frontier. This is issue number 2 of this series. A lot of big things happened last issue. If you're not caught up in the story, click the link below to get caught up, because this is a story you want to keep up on. But getting into this new issue, we see Agent Chase visit the Hall of Justice. She's here to speak with the Justice League. She tries working her way around, not having an actual appointment, but then Superman shows up. He was alerted the moment Chase stepped foot in the Hall of Justice. Superman takes a picture with some kids, and then he begins to walk with Chase down the hallway. "Is it true you have a prison underneath this place?" Chase asks. "Is there a reason for your visit, Cameron?" Superman asks. "Just a friendly chat," Chase says. "Are we friends?" Superman asks. "I thought Superman was everyone's friend," Chase states. "Last time we saw each other, you tried to arrest my wife," Superman says as he walks Chase into a room with the Batman. "What are you investigating, Agent Chase?" Batman asks. Agent Chase has been sent by Director Bones to find out what the Justice League are doing to monitor the multiverse. After the Batman Who Laughs and Perpetua, they need to be more alert. "Since the attack with the Dark Multiverse, we create a network of open communication with the other worlds in the multiverse," Superman says. "We are making moves so that people in our world don't have to worry," Batman states. Agent Chase then tells Batman and Superman that people are still worried though. The Justice League took care of it, isn't going to fly anymore. Also, the Batman Who Laughs, an evil version of Batman, showed up and caused trouble. It's only a matter of time before an evil Superman shows up. What will they do when that happens? He'll be too powerful. Little does Chase know, there's already been many different evil Superman that have attacked. Suddenly, the Hall of Justice gets an alert. Aquaman and Hawkgirl need help in a fight against another fourth world, Brimstone. Chase tries asking where a Wonder Woman is, but Batman and Superman don't answer. They just take off to help Hawkgirl and Aquaman. Agent Chase then leaves the Hall of Justice and reports her info to Bones. Bones tells her to recruit a hero to their side. That hero is Captain Atom. We shift to a page that shows the Justice Incarnate split up across the multiverse, fighting off against different villains. See, last issue, Thomas Wayne crashed in a shuttle. He was then found by the Justice Incarnates. Calvin Ellis has now sent out his team to find the scattered fragments of the ship that Thomas was once in. These fragments are scattered across the multiverse on worlds such as Earth 8, 11, 17, 26, 25, 7, 41, and on Earth 41 we see Machine Head find the final fragments. Or at least the final fragment for now. He will now go back to the House of Heroes to rebuild the giant ship. Meanwhile, at the House of Heroes, Calvin Ellis, President Superman, shows Thomas Wayne a map of the multiverse.
"So a multiverse, huh? Different worlds," Thomas says.
"We have a guidebook and everything," Calvin says, pulling out the guidebook.
"I don't read comic books," Thomas says.
Calvin then ignores Thomas for a quick moment. He asks Harbinger where Barry Allen is. Harbinger tells Calvin that Barry has no travel logs and hasn't returned yet. He's been gone for a while. We know as the reader that Barry has been captured by Darkseid and the Psycho Pirates.
"That's unlike Barry. Thomas, can you tell me everything you remember?" Calvin says.
"I'll do my best," Thomas says. Now, Thomas goes on to explain that he was in Arkham Asylum on Earth Zero. So, yep, guys, Tom King's version of Thomas is still in canon. We then find out that the same hunters that attacked Roy Harper last issue came to Arkham Asylum to capture Thomas. Thomas was then kidnapped and put on a space shuttle. He fought back and made to escape shuttle. Next thing he knew, he was waking up on the Ellis farm.
Harbinger then interrupts reporting to Calvin Ellis that another fragment of the space shuttle has been spotted on Earth 22. Calvin Ellis and Thomas Wayne head there immediately. Yep, they're going to the world of Kingdom Come. Once we're done here, I'll take you back to your Earth. Calvin says, looking at the huge fragments of space shuttle before him. No thanks, Thomas says. Excuse me? Calvin asks. I think having my world destroyed, erased, it messed me up more than I wanted to admit to myself. Thomas states. I can relate, but what about your son, Bruce? Calvin asks. I was angry at Bruce, betrayed myself, fell harder than I ever have, and I don't deserve to see him ever again. If he believes I'm dead, it's for the best. I thought I was protecting my family, but I was wrong. Thomas says, guys, I find this scene very interesting. This is a great way for Joshua Williamson to navigate around Tom King's Batman mess while also providing character developments for Thomas Wayne at the same time. Now, Calvin Ellis then begins to talk about how he's a loner and he doesn't plan on having a family. A man should have a family, Thomas says. This jogging any memories? Calvin says, looking up at the space shuttle. That's when suddenly, Calvin Ellis is blasted into the ground. Yeah, boom! Thomas looks up and sees Magog. Outsiders are no longer welcomed on our world. Magog says, ready to fight. Thomas then walks forward, ready to box. Calvin gets up surprised. He thought Magog had changed his ways. He was supposed to be better on this world. If he is reverted back to his old ways, the big question then is, who else has reverted back to being evil? We shift to Earth Zero. Alan Scott, Obsidian, Mr. Terrific, and Vandal Savage meet up to talk about the disappearance of Jade. Obsidian then finds out that Jade's not the only one missing. There's other heroes like Power Girl, Atom Smasher, Wildcats, Dr. Midnight, Hourman, and more missing. Obsidian then gets mad because Alan knew about people going missing and he didn't check on Jade. We don't have all the facts, son, Alan says. Obsidian then suggests they go knock on all the villains of the JSA's doors and find out who's causing this problem. Once they find out, they'll beat up the villain and save Jade. Vandal Savage then tells Alan that this isn't a missing person's case. This situation is larger than his daughter's rescue. Also, Obsidian shouldn't be here. He's not a part of the totality, and he is merely a distraction. Please, send your brats home so we can continue our work. Vandal Savage says before Alan Scott hits him with a huge green construct of a hammer. If you ever speak to my children like that again, you'll wish you weren't immortal. Alan says, walking off with Obsidian through a portal. Where do you want to go first? Obsidian asks. You were right before. The JSA has a lot of enemies. Let's start in the dark. Alan says, my guess is that they're going to confront Eclipso first, which, if that happens, that'll be awesome. Now guys, we switch to Roy Harper, who is on a motorcycle with a Black Lantern ring on his finger. He wonders why the Black Lantern ring chose him. Is this the reason he's alive? Is there even an oath? What did Hal used to say? Roy says as he remembers a great memory of Hal Jordan, the Green Lantern, giving him insights on how to control a lantern ring. I really like this scene because it's rare that we get an Hal Jordan, Roy Harper interaction, and this one doesn't disappoint. It's really cool. Now, through this memory, Roy is able to get control of the Black Lantern ring, and he begins to fly. How about some target practice? He says as he makes black constructs of villains he's faced before. This is an awesome scene that shows Roy using his Black Lantern ring to just create a black bow and arrow, pretty much. Makes sense, right? Alright, Hal's ring could talk to him, I think. So, talk to me. Why me? Roy says, blasting a big load of Black Lantern energy. You hear a big boom as the Black Lantern ring shows Roy an image of Barry Allen, the Flash. being held captive by Psycho Pirates and Darkseid. Plus, the image shows Thomas Wayne and Lian. Lian being Roy's daughter. This catches Roy off guard. He begins to shout, "Show me my daughter! Where is she? Tell me now!" Darkseid is heard around Roy. Roy begins to lose control of the Black Lantern ring. Someone else is controlling him now. "Come to me, my Black Lantern," they say. Roy then flies up and across a military base. At this military base, Captain Atom flies in. The soldiers salute him as he walks by. This is the Metropolis Air Force Base. Captain Atom is then confronted by Agent Chase. At first, she tries to recruit him into the DEO. Atom refuses. He's retired. He's trying to live the simple life now. Chase then asks Atom a few questions to eventually catch him off guard. This isn't this world's Captain Atom. This is Captain Atom from another Earth in the multiverse. Agent Chase then points her gun and asks, "Where is the real Captain Atom?" "I don't know, but on my world, you and I were friends. You don't understand what's really going on in the multiverse. And I know too much. I can't let you take me in," Captain Atom says as he begins to light up rapidly. He begins to get scared. "He'll find out. He'll come for me. I'm sorry, Cameron," Captain Atom says as he begins to pull his chest apart. Light shines out of his chest, a very bright light. "No, no, no. DEO, this is Agent Chase. I need backup now," Chase says as she steps back. "Darkseid is," Captain Atom says as he completely blows up. You hear a thoom as the Air Force Base explodes. And that is how we end this incredible issue. Now guys, I really like this issue. The mystery is really intriguing and I am very invested. I like Roy Harper being a Black Lantern, plus Darkseid is already proving himself to be an awesome villain again without even showing himself in this issue. Like guys, the backdrop of this issue of Barry being like captured by Psycho Pirate and Darkseid, also with Roy Harper getting controlled by Darkseid at the end of his part of the issue, plus like Captain Atom at the end of the issue blowing up because Darkseid like implants his energy in him. Like, it's just a bunch of epic scenes that get me excited for the rest of the series. You see, it really feels like this issue was a lot of just like setup, right? But the setup wasn't boring. It was really entertaining, and yeah, I'm still getting used to Agent Chase's character, but so far, she's growing on me. I'm liking her. Like, her interactions with Batman, Superman, and Captain Atom are really good. But yeah, guys, that's my thoughts on this issue. Big props to Joshua Williamson. He's delivering a really great miniseries. I'm going to give this issue a 9 out of 10. I definitely recommend you guys check out this issue. Check out this series. This is one of the best DC series coming out right now. But yeah, you guys tell me your thoughts on this issue down below in the comment section. If you like the video, give it a big thumbs up. New to the channel, make sure to subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on my next Infinite Frontier video. And yeah, thanks for watching, and peace out.